Commissioner, Board of Directors, and member schools of the Ohio High School Athletic Association extend to each of you a cordial welcome to this girls' state volleyball tournament match, the Division III State Championship between the Tigers from Huron High School and the Warriors of Edina High School. Spectators as well as coaches and players are expected to conduct today a day in which we honor those men and women who have so courageously served and continue to serve our country. As we rise to join in the singing of our national anthem, please remember all our veterans, those in active service, and especially those who have made the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom.
Banner yet brave.
introducing the official teams. First, the Tigers from Huron. Taryn Graham, Rachel Stelzer, Samantha Wechter, Ellie Justice, Hannah Figgins, Justine Butler, Erin O'Reilly, Melissa Mober, and the starting six players for the Tigers. Number 13, Taylor Slaughterbeck. Number 10, Devin Koenig. Number 14, Adriana DeLuca. Number 6, Jesse Medea. Number 9, Caitlin Summer. And number 11, Devin Grendel. The Tigers are coached by assistants Keith Lotzinger, Sean Rice, Sean Patton, and the head coach of Huron is Don Wood. Introducing the Warriors, Almedina. Alyssa Kennedy, Michelle Ackley, Kirsten Jones, Lexi Roll, Katie Corey, Kara Coy, Logan Battle, Laura Chenoweth, Misty Pierce, and now the starting six players for the Warriors. Number 7, Hannah Halcombe. Number 9, Kelsey Polano. Number 1, Jenny Quixby. Number 13, Olivia Arledge. Number 10, Allison Morgan. Number 8, Kirsty Yates. Warriors are coached by assistants Jimmy Hutton, Julia Leisure, Bethany Dix, Donna Atchison, Josh Hickson, and the head coach of Adina is Laura Smith.
Warriors.
Jenny Krinsky. Thank you. Jeffrey Barano. Taylor Schlutterbeck.
Thank you.
Mount Warriors. We would like to thank our Ball Retrievers for today's championship match. Need a round of applause. Thank you. Dusty Bellano. Justine Butler, number 3, in for the Tigers. Thank you. Delay of game. Timeout. Adina. Thank you. Jesse Galano.
Runner-up, but this one's got to be sweet for you. You went 4th, 3rd, trophy reads, Champion 2009 Division III Huron High School.
Captains and seniors nearby, they're going to want all of you in the press conference.
Can we stay here now?
Yes. Yeah, they want to keep us close.
Can we go change? I should wait.
Just wait. I'd wait.
Coach, if you want to introduce all the players you have with you real quick.
Starting to my right is our libero, Taryn Graham. Defensive specialist, number 14er is Adriana DeLuca. Number one, senior center, Melissa Moberg. Number six, senior outside hitter, Jesse Miedema. Next to me is number 11, senior center, Devin Grindow.
And we'll take a quick opening statement from you and then take a few questions.
I couldn't be any more pleased with the group of kids. Not a whole lot of people thought that we'd be sitting in this spot back at the beginning of September. And they've worked hard all season to improve, and they have showed steady progress throughout the season to get to this point. So a lot to be proud of. This is one of the sweeter moments for us.
Coach, you mentioned, we must have said three or four times on the way down here, that opening loss to Edison where it could have been 100 straight conference matches. Now that it's all over, just how important, I don't want to say important that they lost, but how much was learned from that?
Hold on a second, let me count something up. 1, 2, 3. We got a winning streak of 7 at the end of the season. I'm extremely proud of. That's the streak that counts. You know, back at the beginning of the season, that was a lot of motivation for teams around the conference to stop that league streak. Really, we didn't focus a whole lot on that. As a matter of fact, most Huron people didn't know about it. So, you know, us losing that first match, I've said it before, is probably the best thing ever happened to us. And these guys are motivated and focused to come back after that. So, but the one streak I'll talk about is 7 wins in a row at the end of the season. That's the big one.
What did you say at the timeout that you took in the third game? The last.
Am I allowed to repeat what I said in there?
No. It was great.
PG-13. Well, I told them that, you know, Adina was not going to go away. They weren't going to roll over for us, and they showed that. They came back to tie the game. I don't know if they took a lead in that third game, but I know they tied it late in the game. So, you know, that's credit to them and their coach. They weren't going to roll over for anybody. And I emphasize that to our kids, you know, got to make plays and don't sit back and wait for someone else to make a play.
Jesse, did something click when you lost the 24-21 lead yesterday in game 3 and you didn't lose again and now you have a gold medal on
your hand? We wanted to win. Like, I don't know, after we lost that third game, it was just like, we need to go. Like, we need to just get it. I don't know. We all wanted it so bad, so it definitely has helped us throughout today.
Yeah. You have no clue what you want to say.
No, I don't know. I'm so happy.
I know.
I can't think right now.
Melissa, your mom was a point guard.
Definitely.
Mom was a point guard. But I guess, do you girls, you know, 10 years ago to the day and date, Coach Wood took his first team down here, and they won a state title, and he had to pierce his ear and shave his head after that. So,
yeah. We played for each other. We didn't play for
that. Is there going to be anything after the fact?
No, he's getting out easy.
Yeah.
We thought
that,
you tattoo.
Know what? I didn't want to make that bet. I threw it out there, but you know what? They played for each other all along. They didn't need to play for something like that. They wanted to win for the entire team. And when you have a team playing with that type of mindset, you know, that's more important than anything I could do to my body, my skin.
What do you, at the beginning of the game, what do you guys whisper to each other?
Yes.
Can you say
now.
It?
Motivational words. We say now. The time is now to get the job done.
Now.
Now.
Okay.
Now's
yeah.
time. That's what we say.
Yeah.
Time is now.
Motivation.
One more question for the players.
How does it feel?
Awesome.
Feels great.
Overwhelming.
I wanted this forever. I don't know about anybody else.
But. Forever. Forever.
Got it.
Is it sweeter winning this than the J.O.? National.
Oh yeah, I say yeah, just because you have your whole town with you, mm-hmm. you have everyone supporting you. Like J.O., you don't, it's just...
And
like,
we're all best
yeah.
friends.
Mm-hmm.
Grown up.
You celebrate yes. with your friends and your town. It's great.
I might add, no one picked it up yesterday. I don't know if you did, Mark. Yesterday, Taryn did get her 1,000th dig.
Okay, yep.
And, she needed 6, and she got well over that yesterday.
And she had 28 today.
Yeah, saw it.
So she's, what's her final total?
At this point, she had 28, and 50, that's about 646.
646 this season?
Oh, I'm sorry, 1,046. Thank you. 1,046.
Nice job.
So, something that should be added.
So she had 994 and one in the ocean.
Yeah.
Real quick, you mentioned patience yesterday.
Yes.
Do you feel that's what
absolutely.
Wanted today?
Yeah.
That helped us get through yesterday and then today as well. You know, we didn't force the issue when we weren't supposed to. When we did, we gave up point runs. And Dina did a nice job capitalizing on that. But, yeah, a lot of people have a hard time with that philosophy. You know, a lot of our own people. You know, everybody wants them to hit the ball every time. But, you know, you got to make teams make plays. When you don't have an opportunity to make one, but don't force it.
Good. Coach, ladies, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. girls' volleyball team, the girls' volleyball coaching staff.
Best thing that has ever happened to us. rest of the way takes the hard work and determination that all of us have put into every day. It also takes the world's greatest coaching staff, coaches who are with us every day working with us, and Coach Pat, who goes out, drives across the state and scouts for us, and puts together the most detailed scouting reports I've ever laid eyes on. And we have the world's greatest cameraman, Don Hardy, and we have the first. We also have to thank the administration that supports us, from the board to the people we see every day at school.
Day, Austin, I wasn't there for this, but our good friend Matthew Neckbottle, where is he? He's right over there. They were driving around, and Austin said, I gotta call this girl. So, but he was a little nervous, so instead of using his own phone, he borrowed Matt's phone. And when Adrian picked up, he got a little freaked out and gave her a fake name. what was that name there, Austin?
David Sparks.
David Sparks.
She just broke up with a guy named David, so she was worried about this David guy coming back.
He picked the wrong name. So, but yeah, no, seriously, I was there from the beginning. I was also there for the first date, and I believe in a brilliant display of tact, my first words to Adrian were, damn, you really are tall. And also another fun story. At the end of the date, Austin came and talked to me. Of course, he was totally stoked, and he's like, damn. So, but in all seriousness, it's been great, you know, watching the two of them grow together as a couple, and, you know, finding out what an amazing, beautiful, intelligent, awesome person Adrian is, and, you know, it's just been so great to see the two of them together, and, you know,